What Mama Never Told You About Laundry. The key to sustainability, the key to fight fast fashion, is to buy good materials and to take care of them. Okay, so laundry is a daunting task. It's a task that not everyone likes to do. And if you're like me, when I moved away from my family and I had to do it alone, it was this whole world of mistakes that I've made that cost me really garments that I like, cherish, and I want to keep nice and neat. First and foremost, what you need to do is start from the beginning. To not make it a daunting experience. When you're taking off the item, let's say I'm taking off this sweater and I wanna wash it. When I take it off, it's already wrong side out. I keep it that way because when you wash your items wrong side out, you prevent pilling to happen, those teeny tiny wool pieces. You prevent the friction of the fabric. You make sure that the fabric is washed without it being damaged. So wrong side out, and I already start sorting the items when I put them in the laundry big bin. So in the bin, I have these mesh-like bags that you carry like that, and I do three piles of these. So one of these have whites or lights, one of these has darks, and one has colors, like very vivid colors. And what I do then is, either if you have the luxury of washing each mesh bag alone, that's great. If you cannot do that and you will use all mesh bags at once, which I do a lot to save money, I have these. I keep them in this plastic bag because when I was moving, it was more convenient to keep it like that. But these are Dr. Beckman's sheets. They come like tissue paper like that. And what this does is that when you put it, any color that bleeds, this kind of soaks it up. So it makes sure that your colors do not bleed together. Make sure that you do not go ham on the temperature. You don't need a higher temperature than 30 degrees if you're not trying to kill crazy bacteria or remove crazy stains or make clothes whiter or inject a color in the clothes. Higher temperature, not only is it expensive on the electricity bill, not sustainable at all, it also damaged the fabrics. Most of the fabrics nowadays comes with elastic in them, and elastic is a type of plastic. So heat is gonna melt that. That's why your garments are gonna be misshaped after you take them out of the wash. That's one thing. Second thing, some clothes really shrink with heat, which is a bad thing. Materials like wool, they get shrunk with the high heat. So you want to keep that to a minimum. I usually wash my items on 30 degree wash. When it comes to socks and delicates, I also have smaller mesh bags for these. This is a one with zipper. It's a little bit more expensive, and I'm gonna get to the uses of this one. But I put socks in one of these and underwear in one, in another one. And what that does is that it allows me to put them in the one wash without needing to wash again and again, and separates them from other garments. Plus, it keeps them from being lost in the washing machine. Before you put the items in the machine, make sure to treat odor or stains outside before you get the clothes together. Odor is not good, and washing alone wouldn't kill the scent. So how to kill the scent? Very easy. What you do is, before you put it, soak it in water and vinegar for half an hour. So any clothes with odor, like your socks or your gym clothes, something that is really smelly, just put it, soak it, like put it in a jug with water and vinegar for half an hour, and that will kill the bacteria that causes the scent. Afterwards, just put it back in the washing machine to wash with everything else. Another cool thing, if you know what I mean, when you have deodorant stains and scents, well, there are a couple of methods. You can go and buy something for the deodorant scent and stain right away. I have the Dr. Beckman one I'm going to show you in a bit. Or you can spray vinegar at the armpit area and let it sit. But for whites, that yellows the fabric. Like, it's not going to get rid of the stain, but from the scent. Also, another thing is to use vodka. Buy cheap one for this, just put in a spray bottle and spray it on the deodorant area, and that gets rid also of the scent. Right away after doing that, put it in the machine and then it's gonna wash and be smell and scent free. When it comes to spot treating, I love the Dr. Beckman specialized treatments for stains. Every stain has a different thing to solve it. I usually buy from Dr. Beckman three main ones. This is the only one left. This one is for the deodorant stain. As you can see, this is for deodorant stains. They have another one for oil stains. I have that as well when you drop any greasy foods or something like this. They also have one for pens when the pen bleeds. So I buy these, they're so cheap, and before washing, I just put this on the stain and wash it. Some things are not recommended to be washed many times, and you have to do the math here. It's not advised to wash wool many times. It's also not advised to wash any jackets many times, if not at all. It's not advised to wash jeans. I know, gross. So how to refresh these and how to wash them when they're really stinky and you need to wash them? Textile fresheners. These textile fresheners, it doesn't matter which brand you buy. What I do is when I take off that garment, I spray a little bit of this on it. And what that does, it really works on the scent to make it feel as if it's washed. It's also important to keep it aired. So hang it on a rack to really ensure that it's going to be aired and it's not going to be trapping that scent. And when the scent of any of these garments start to get, usually at the crotch area, or if it's a wool sweater, it's on the underarms, the vodka or alcohol or vinegar works just perfect for removing that. Okay, so all of these things are beginner friendly. Like, they're, you're doing one wash cycle. It's just you take care of certain things before. If you want to go the extra route, being more fancy and taking care of your items more, because that's the case with me right now, I have invested in some things like my trench coat, the Burberry trench coat, the blazer that is cool, the wool sweaters I have, and the cashmere sweaters. How do you wash these? I usually do not vigorously wash them. What I do is I fill a basin with water. Just general rule, buy things that are for fine textiles or things that are natural. So I fill the basin with water, I put a little bit of this in it, and then I soak my wool item for around 15 minutes, maximum 30 minutes. I rinse it out with water several times until the water runs clear, and then I put it to dry. I usually put it flat on the drying rack so that it doesn't get misshapen, because wool tends to get misshapen. If it's something like a jacket or a trench coat or a cool skirt, something that is expensive, I'm gonna give you an example. This is my Burberry trench coat. If I wanna wash this and put it in the washing machine, which I did with my Michael Kors down jacket, what I do is put the garment wrong side out, okay? Close the garment so that the zippers or anything like that does not scratch the garment itself. Fold it really, really well and put it in one of these bags. It's super small, so it doesn't get a lot of things. This comes in sizes, but I buy it like that so that the item is really compact and doesn't keep moving a lot, because that friction might ruin the item. And I close it and I put it in the wash, again on 30 degrees, or if you can't put it, if your machine has this wool or hand wash cycle, then I do it in that manner. For my underwears, I usually do not put them in the washing machine. That ruined a lot of my underwear before. And in order to keep your underwear living a little bit longer, what I do is a soap. It's pretty well loved, as you can see, I use it. So it smells like grandma washing your clothes. But what I do is I get the crotch area of the underwear, I do this, I rub it against each other, and then put it in a basin, again filled with detergent, the one I use for the wool material. So I soak my delicates only. I do not put them in washing machine. So when it comes to whites and blacks and anything that fades, whites, I usually do this mix of vinegar, baking soda, and bleach. in a wash together, or I buy sometimes the special treatments for whites and make one cycle. Another thing to save you time and money is these. These are the washing capsules. You probably saw them, you felt that they are expensive, but the best thing is you really need one of these for a big wash, which is what I've used. It keeps my laundry smelling really, really good. It also has these softeners, so I don't need to use softeners. And also, if you didn't know, if you use too much of detergent on your clothes, that might ruin the clothes. So I use minimal of that. After washing, Angie, what should I do? Stay away from dryers. Stay away from them. Naturally, drying your clothes is the best and only way for the clothes to be good. I know you want to run and have things ready to wear, but that's going to damage the fabric on the longer run. So I usually put them on the rack to dry. That's the first thing. I don't like ironing, so I do the laziest thing. So I do this to the garments after they're done, like after they're out of the wash, and then I try to hang them on a coat rack. What that does, it's gonna make the item not have creases, or the least creases out there. For example, things that are easily tangled or crumbled, if you put them in these folded, your washing is going to have minimal effects on the crumbling of them. This saved my life. This is just a steamer for travel, and I don't use this for travel only. It's the only iron I own. And as you can see, it has this part, it had water in it, like a water bottle. And the best thing, this folds. I don't want to fold it because, yeah, I have this. You put water in here and you steam your items while they are hung. I would suggest, because a lot of people don't like these because they don't get you the results of an iron, to buy these, the travel steamers, with 1500 watts or above. Those are the only ones that are going to really iron your clothes. Anything less is just not powerful enough. The best thing about this is that you can travel with this without this tank. This fits any water, plastic water bottle in it. So you can use the one in the hotel or something. And this is really, really light to carry around with. If you have a garment that started to pill, in the first place, I always recommend to avoid the pilling to start. So avoiding it instead of treating it. But if you had to treat it, two things I use. On daily basis, on items that has pilling that starts to show, I use a defusser. I got this very cheaply. And what you do is that you put it on and you rub it against the item, and it does have those peelies coming off. But this not on intense cases. This is for daily maintenance, okay? And I do this a lot as a daily maintenance. After you finish with it, a lint roller. This, you roll it on the garment, and I usually do not lint roll right after that. So I do this when I'm taking off my garment every day, if that garment has pilling happening or occurring all the time. But when I'm going out every day in the morning, I have to make sure I run one of these around my body, because we have hair falling on our jumpers, those things on it, and this makes sure that the garment, if there is something that is gonna make peels come out, this removes it right away. I've ruined an item before. It has a hole because I've used the razor, which is no. But these are combs. As you can see here, this combs away the peelies. You stretch the garment and you start to comb, and the peels come off. This is the best way for extreme cases, peeling on your clothes. Protect your clothes from wetness, especially the rain, because sometimes it's also very dirty. So that will protect those clothes and make it last longer. I hope in this video I covered the take care of them, and I'm going to talk about materials in another video, but for now that's all the information I can give you. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed that video. Comment down below if you have any laundry tips for people to know, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.